Today is a special one, y'all. It's like for many reasons, but it's not gonna be an easy one because I got so much to talk about. I actually haven't even shared this with anybody, really. I mean, not even the crew. I came in, today is kind of quiet, and just because there's so much going on in the world, and I had a tough, very tough weekend. But it's like before I even get into why, I always we go to the pick of the day. And I got to show, this is the pick of the day of my youngest son, Zen Scott Cannon, right there. So, before the show started in the summertime, Zen was born in June, on June 23rd, actually. And, it was a great day. Actually, y'all know I got a lot of kids. Zen's my youngest, and it was so exciting. And I got, I did the introducing Zen photo, and so during the summer, it was really exciting, but I always noticed, as he got, 1 month was great. By the time he got 2 months, he was just, the most loving. We called him Z-chilling. He was just always smiling, always having just the most beautiful spirit. But I always noticed he had, to me, it felt like a sinus thing. It was like a cough. And I just wanted to check it out. Sometimes, early on, we thought, because, babies get fluid in their lungs and stuff, so we thought, he'll cough it out, and that's what they would say. But he always had this real interesting breathing. And then, by the time he was 2 months old, I noticed, he's just the cutest little boy. I had these, big eyes. And I also noticed, he had, a nice-sized head. He had, I call it a cannon head. All my kids got really nice, round heads, rock, roll, golden. Everybody had, even me, I had, a real, cabbage patch kid type of head. So we didn't think anything about it. He had a normal, cannon head. But I really wanted to, take him to the doctor to get the breathing and the sinus things checked out. So we thought it would be, a routine process. And we went in just to check his sinuses, and they actually said his sinuses were pretty cool. But then by the time we found out that he had another condition. And I think it was called, if I'm not mistaken, but it was where it was fluid that was building up in his head, and that was the cause of his head was starting to get big. And when we found out it was more of a malignant tumor in his head. And so immediately we had to have surgery, it was brain surgery. We put a shunt in his head, and we were hoping for the best. And, the shunt would go down, it was like a tube that would go inside and drain all of the fluid out, so his head would be normal and, he would be able to function. But then the doctors were concerned, and when I say I have to thank all of the doctors at the Children's Hospital of Orange County, CHOC, out there. They were beautiful nurses, the people, Trinity, the hospice care, all of those people. They were really educating and kind of letting us know everything that was going on. So we were faithful and hopeful for that time. And then it was carried on. He was still just playing with all his brothers and sisters. I get an opportunity. I embraced every moment because something like that, that was even them with all the other kids. And I just got an opportunity to try to spend as much time. And I really want to say, I'm so grateful to my entire family for coming together during this time and being so loving and not judgmental of me or any of those things. And I really have to say, Zen's mom, Alyssa was just amazing, the strongest woman I've ever seen, because she never had an argument, never was angry, was emotional when she needed to be, but was always the best mom and continues to be the best mom possible. So I gotta say thank you to my entire family, but specifically to Alyssa. And Thanksgiving, because up until then, he was just like all my other kids, just loving and fun. But Thanksgiving, we had a interesting turn, and the process sped up. you know, and ultimately, if anybody knows how cancer is, it was cancer in the brain. And the tumor began to grow a lot faster. And so we knew that the time was... So this weekend, you know, I made a valid effort to spend the most quality time I could spend with Zen. And we woke up on Sunday. Got to spend, you know, the weekend with them, spend the night, and we woke up on Sunday, and I was like, I just feel like I want to go to the water. You know, we're close to the ocean, and, you know, we kind of got a chance to go to the ocean. And usually on Sundays, I kind of handle everything I had to handle with the family, and then I fly back to New York. I rush back so I could be here for you all. And so, you know, but I wanted to make sure that, you know, I had allowed the sun to rise and, you know, kind of hold my son. And in the holding my son for the last time. But it was a beautiful setting to spend that whole day. It was interesting because even as I was holding him, I was still preparing my day as it normally went to come back and, you know, come here and still, I didn't know what it was going to be, but even by the time I got in the car and was headed to the airport, I had to turn around. I turned around and I, not only did we get to see the sunrise, but we got to see the sunset too. And I didn't know how I was gonna handle today. I didn't know how, but I just really wanted, you know, I wanted to grieve with my family. You know what I mean? There's no people who love you. And I didn't want to make it about any pageantry or any of that type of stuff, so I kind of went back and forth for what I should do, but I felt like, it, you know, I was always talking about you don't just go through it, you grow through it, you keep pushing, you know what I mean? And I have so much faith in the Lord, I have so much faith in God, and I never, you know, people were often telling me I should pray for miracles, and I did pray for the miracle. I prayed for the miracle of God's strength, and that's why I'm here with you guys today, because I know, you know, he puts the most and heaviest weight on the shoulders of his strongest soldiers, so I'm here to show that I can fight through this. I'm feeling it. I'm vulnerable. I'm open, y'all, but I'm going to make it through, and this is a special show dedicated to my beautiful son, Zen. Dr. Laura Berman is here. Y'all know she's my daytime therapist. She has helped me with so many things and so many areas in my life. And Dr. Laura has also dealt with some similar situations in her own life as a parent. So she's the perfect person to talk to. She's here today. I know so many people out there have experienced the kind of pain and grief that I'm experiencing right now. We all know it. This is that time to say you never know what somebody's going through. Hug your people. Hug your family. Kiss somebody. Tell them you love them. It's the holidays. And we're here. We'll be right back.